Now, again, I'm not going to go too much into what Egyptologists say because it really is a waste of time. You now have a working knowledge of chematology and how different it is than Egyptology. That has a different background of what Egypt was about. And we call it the indigenous tradition. And I met the man who is my teacher. And his name is Abdel Hakim Awiyan. Well, in the early 1990s, he also revealed himself as an indigenous wisdom keeper, part of an oral tradition. Well, it's also part of Africa, but no one has ever considered, certainly not Egyptologists, that there is an oral tradition. And Hakim represents that. His tribe, the Awiyani tribe, which is called the Eye tribe, everybody's wearing an Eye of Horus, an Eye of Ra, represents this tribe. They not only kept the history of their own tribe, they kept the history of all tribes. So what we present to you is over 65,000 years of oral tradition. And stating that there was a previous civilization before what is known as dynastic Egypt, before what is known as Egypt to Egyptologists, that existed and was very highly advanced, built the pyramids, carved the Sphinx. Here we are to her, and her is the key operative word. You've heard many different stories of the Sphinx. It's Harem Hakit, it's Horus in the horizon. It represents a king, Khafre, making an offering to the sun. Well, according to the indigenous tradition, it's she. Her name is Tefnut. She represents an aspect of the Great Mother, because to the Kemetians, the sky was feminine. Feminine, female, represented that which created it, that which is uncreated, called Nut, N-U-T. When Nut wanted to manifest on the earth, on the planet, she spit on the earth. Tefnut means the spittle of Nut, and it was right here at Giza. And according to this tradition, she is the oldest statue on our planet that we know of now. There may be things older, but that her date is 54,000 years, not 4,500, like Zahir Wass will tell you, and not he, like Zahir Wass will tell you. The face as it is today is that of a black African woman's face. She was the mother of the first king of the first dynasty, whose name was Hor-Aha, or Men-Aha. The Greeks called Menes, and to honor his mother, he had the face of the Sphinx recarved to her face. It's not a man's face to any degree, and it's a black African face, without a doubt. It's not a Caucasian male face. Not by any degree. But it's not the original face. The original face was probably more like a lioness human face. We'll show you a little bit more of that later as another netter will come up in my current book, How Patriarchy Arose. They put a false beard on her. And it's not there anymore, is it? She spit it out. She said, what the hell are you trying to do to me? And you can obviously see it wasn't part of the original structure and not there today. This, he says, is a textbook example of water erosion. Not wind and sand, as Zahi Wass and Mark Lehner will tell you. Could not have been done in the last 4,500 years. It hasn't rained significantly in this area of the world. Like I said, it rained one day. That's probably all it's going to rain all year. 4 inches of rain a year at Giza. Hasn't rained significantly in 8,000 to 10,000 years here. So it has to be the Sphinx is older than that. And that's very important when you're dealing with chematology as opposed to Egyptology. And what Schock has meticulously documented for us, it is the harder layers of this limestone that are more eroded, meaning only rainfall beating down at an angle for thousands of years could have caused this type of erosion. She has to be older than 10,000 years. And Schock is not alone. When he gave a presentation at the American Society of Geologists in San Diego in 1995, I think it was, he had 250 geologists lined up after his presentation to verify, to stand with him, not caring what Egyptologists said, to document that he's absolutely right about this erosion.
Ignore. Just refuse to publish any facts of African history that don't go along with our racial theories.
When black contribution to civilization is too obvious, let's find a way to attribute it to outside white influence.
Return to glory, the powerful stirring of the black man.
Human civilization started in Africa.